Yes, sir.
Make it five.
What we'll do, we're just gonna do some basic kids. Every karate technique is designed to disable your opponent. If you do it correctly with enough power, and you get a vital strike. So, karate is designed for the element of surprise and the fast kill. Not to fight for about 15 minutes. So if you do these techniques, you don't need a fancy 360-degree spinning kick or a jump spinning kick or bread and butter kicking or self-defense technique. It's basic, it's all you need. You can do it powerful enough to surprise your opponent. So I'm just gonna start off with a basic kick, like roundhouse kick, thigh kick, semi thigh kick. Just to show you how I developed my technique, how I kick, and probably very similar to the way the Garza taught you. It's a little bit different, don't worry about it. Just here to help you if you want to pick up your tennis. Learn something. We still haven't enjoyed ourselves.
Sir.
Biggest guy.
Let's make five line drills.
Here's one. I'm going to start with the roundhouse kick. So, I'm going to do a kick now. I haven't worked out in a long time, so cut me a little slack. I'm going to hold this up. I'm just going to do a roundhouse kick. Do one, I'm going to explain what I do, what I did, and where I'd like to get to. So I'm here, we'll get set up in a good stand. Low center gravity, you have better balance. Stand up real far on the kick, you have good balance. When you kick, you stand on one leg, right? When I make contact, I'm on one leg. So I'm going to hit. Okay? Again. So if I come in and kick, I want to kick that way. I want to generate a lot of speed to the target. I want to aim at the target. I want to make contact with the target. My head's staying at one level. I'm coming through, pointing that knee towards my target. My leg put it back here to cock. Getting here, this one kind of pulling back. Hit. And I'm tightening up every muscle. Bam, right there. Arm.
She'll step out. Everybody else sound off. One to five.
Six.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four. Five.
One, two, three.
Once you get your number, go to your line.
Four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One.
Back up, guys.
Everybody do about, like, at least 3 to 5 kicks. Then you get this. We're going.
Thank you.
Foot, hold the throw back. The other way is to tie on the foot, pointing the foot. The the side kick, I want just this part of the heel to hit my target, not the whole bottom of my foot. My foot is kicking this way. My ankle's not locked down. My foot gives. So you get the target and give, you know, you get good impact or a good hit on the target. I want the ankle, right. I want the ankle to lock down, this way, and my ankle to work. I'm kicking my target. I'm putting here up, here popping up, this way, right here, locked. Is this something I was noticing?
Sir.
Lock the ankle down. Good feet.
Sir.
Thank you, sir. Forward, up, already cocking, kick, I'm lifting the hip roll under. That's what this is, what? It's a ball with foot hit, 10 and block. Foot block, my toes throw back, we hit with the ball. I'm gonna come in, run here.
Good at it. I think Morgan started us. Oh yeah, she does. She comes here. She was doing it with her dad, and her dad got the black. She got to that. She was asking Danny if she could see the ceremony or something like that. Asking the girl then.
All right, everybody stop. Come on. Stop for a minute. Thank you. So we're going to do a flying kick. So I'm doing a flying kick. I'm leaving the ground with the opposite foot. Okay? Let's just leave it last. So I can do it from running, skipping, or, you know, skip side kick is different. So if I'm here, skip side kick means I'm skipping from here. I'm hitting that foot, man. So here, left skip. The jump side kick is up from here, hit. Back. Up, hit. And a flying side kick looks more like running, or I can do this from right here, from it here, hit. So, we're going to run, or just take a couple steps.
Jump on the back and push it over.
That was very good. Is to, you know, when you take the technique, you get kind of a rhythm going. make one technique, that leads you to the next technique. So, and when you get to more advanced katas, you can put a little bit of your own feeling into it. It doesn't have to look exactly the same rhythm as like I do it, or someone else does it. You know, you got to have some of your own feeling into it, your own technique into it. You know, make it look like it flows. I hate getting up judging katas. When you see a kata, even the most basic, in fact, the hardest katas to do are the basic. Every little flaw shows up. One technique goes in the next technique and there's a flow there. Okay, and I don't go to the next technique until it completes that first technique. So if I was just doing a basic, a very, very basic kata, just like maybe down block, punch. I'll start off here, you know, you bow in, start off, ready stand. And when you begin, I'm gonna turn, look, and block. And then basically I've got a good stance, a good forward stance, feet are shoulder width apart, I'm this way, hands here, and this hand's here. Just blocking above the knee, like a down block. When I go forward, punch. And the punches, what I see a lot of times guys punching, they're down blocking, just sort of dividing from here to here. When I step in the punch, I see a lot of people doing this. They'll punch this way.
Go ahead.
Not here. So if I'm fighting an imaginary opponent, and I punch over here, I'm missing. Punch in the center. You know, there's your target area and the space. So you have to hang the technique or the imaginary target. And again, I might not do it exactly like the other one, but basically. I'm going to try to do a form. This is a kind of advanced form. It's called the kick form. Probably haven't ever seen it. Al's probably seen it. Iron horse form. Batate or Bata.
We're not doing the last time.
You haven't done that? Those are kind of all traditional katas. You know, from school to school, the moves may vary a little bit. You know, you might have a little variation. It may have started off centuries ago exactly the same, the first person who invented that power. But through the generations from school to school, each of them had their own little flavor, little variation on it, so it changes a little bit. When you go to big tournaments or the world championship, you know, most of them are pretty similar, but they might be a little bit different, and it doesn't really matter that much as long as you get the team. When I judge them, this, or if they start off with a hammer blow, it doesn't really matter. But I'm going to do this in kata. A series of kicks and movements, you know, going five seed. When you get a
who's going to go first?
I good. Very good. I'm not going to point anybody out or anything. I'm just going to point out things maybe that I saw for the judge that I would like to see. What I like for him to do at Kata, when I look at Kata and judges, what I like to see, even when I was teaching a lot, bringing up students, I like to see a lot of intensity in Kata, very good eye contact, not just with me or the judge, but with that person, the imaginary opponent that you're fighting. So if I'm moving this direction, I'm going to be looking at the floor, turn, and look at the front behind. I want to, my head turn the split second or simultaneously to the technique here, this way, up here. My head, my upper body stays still throughout these movements. I like to see the technique go, block the technique, block, and then go to the next. Most guys did that very well. Watch it. Eye contact, stances. Content is important, but it's a lot more important how you put it together and how you complete the technique. Now, what I didn't like, none of you guys did this, but I don't like to see is if someone is like, man, you know, after the contest or the tournament. That was the hardest kata I ever performed. A lot of hard technique. Well, if you can't complete some of the technique in that kata, then you have to make up some other area. If I don't kick very well, in other words, I want my hand technique to stand out. If I'm very good with kicks, I want to show off the kicks. So, emphasize the good thing and work on the bad thing. Not everyone does everything perfect. Did. most people don't. They don't. Everybody has a little weak area here and there, and concentrating on those hard areas. This kata looks very good. Very important for eye contact, movement, and direction you're going, and good stances. Especially in traditional kata, I want to see the difference between a forward stance, a back stance, a side leg stance, a parallel stance, bar stance, whatever you want to call it. Those stances, I want to see a distinct difference in those stances and not kind of jumbled up, half stances. And a very good balance, you want to display those things. So, kind of three basic things you display is actually top and pole, but power, that's a very good one. Power, I want power in the techniques. I don't want to throw a technique just to throw it out there. And if I've got a shido or a center block, I don't want to just throw it out. If I'm coming out from it, stop. That's kind of technique, the difference between throwing it out, going through the motion, whipping it out, popping it, coming back. That's the whole idea behind this kata. It's kind of like an exercise or sparring without a opponent. But there's set technique. Like a good kicker, you know, he does a good high kick, very good balance. I know, it's a good thing. So, must be related to Al. No, seriously. No, seriously. Very, very good kick. I mean, that was excellent kicking. The only thing I can say to that is your hand technique. Not real hard, but I mean, kicks overpowered that.
What?
kid I'm talking about, that's what I like to say. He had everything he had in the Kata. Big guy. And moved very well for big guy. A couple of kicks. Not that great. Some of them very, very good. But the intensity in that Kata is exactly what I like. Like obviously, I want to see that kind of intensity. Everything he had, his weight was planted. Bam, his technique was there. He moved, then he sent me the eyes and the head. Sometimes we'll see that. It's kind of important. Used to, in the old days, you did a kata and you missed a key off point, you got nothing for it. So, like you said, you didn't do the key off. Just a little long trivia. If you're doing a kata and you happen to forget it, I don't know it. Probably most of the other judges don't know the kata, so don't give it away by changing. Break in there and you stop, and then it's very obvious. So, I mean, you did everything else, a little bit of soft hand.
second, sir.
You second.
I
think that, you know, all of you just caught a very, very good. Good intro. That shows.
Go ahead.
That shows. If you have a good instructor, you're going to be very good. All you guys are doing very, very good. It shows up. And that's why I think that Al asked me to, and I believe it's a very good instructor. Again, that was a very good caller. Not too much to say about it. Still young. Sure, you know, guys, I mean, still growing, good growth first. Things click later. You get a little more testing. Right there, run away, you have good power. A couple of minor things. Really nothing. Good, I'd like a good power to move down. Lock, a little bit more power into it. A little bit more tension. What I was saying earlier is you go into the technique, snap it, lock it, and go to the next technique. It's really very good. Shut it. Flow, it's very good. One thing I would say is lock it. Some we used to teach. If I'm talking to someone, I want to start with okay. Here's the difference. Here's what I'm trying to point out. If I'm doing a key hop, what is a key hop designed to do? Other than getting their attention. I think out there. Key hop is designed kind of twofold. It does two things. It startles your opponent, and it gives you extra ability for extra power. Key hop. That's why when you see guys breaking boards and working together, picking stuff, it gives you a little extra ability. If you don't do it correctly, it doesn't work. I'm talking. This is tough. I do it. Key hop. That's not a key hop. I'm just talking. I'm just saying the word. Yeah, that's the low federal sound that comes from the atmosphere. That's yeah. Tanked up in here. If I get hit, when I'm key hopping, if I'm talking, just talking, if someone hits me in the stomach, I'm going to take a cold. You know, it's going to hurt. If I tighten up, now it's tightened up. It won't hurt. So it's twofold. That's, you know, the traditional kata is. A lot of people don't make a big deal out of it, but I like to see it. I like to see that low guttural sound. The way we used to teach it sometimes is if we had most class people who weren't doing it quite correct, we'd line them up, lay them down, and we started kicking them in the stomach until they tightened up and did a proper key-off. If you can't do a proper key-off, talking like I'm talking right now, people from the throat and mouth, be from the abdomen. But at this point, think that. Yeah. And it was fun for us to kick people.
Ready to begin, sir? I'm going to cut it.
I'm going to give you a couple of things I used to work on and what I thought about. Yeah. Like a heart stand, saddle stand. Center gravity is fine. When you do a kick, it has to be over your supporting leg. If I'm doing a technique where my weight is far, like a front kick, a heart stand, hip kind of centered over my body. It's not out of position this way. They're all centered. If I'm trying to kick, I'm up here and I start to do a kick. I'm going to have my spine, my center gravity over the supporting leg and get me stretched out. I have a bend, I'm going to bounce. If I have it right here and I'm going to kick, I'm coming out. I'm going to bend, so I start to get my balance, I'm dropping down. But it's going to grab, I'm going to kick. If I'm here, I'm kick, then I'm going. A technique you can do. Help you with your balance, remember what I said, your balance is up here. So it's both your body. The mass of your body is where you're going to go. I'm doing a kata. I'm going from one technique to the next. My hands are like this, and I'm going to start coming into this. I can't keep my upper body tight. I'm loose. If I'm up from here, I'm going from here to here, and my hands are like this, I'm loose. I'm kind of limp. That means I don't have control over my upper body. So what I want to do is when I'm going from point A to point B, move it from one technique to the next technique, my hands are tight. I have my hands tight, I'm tight up here. Right across the chest, very abdomen, tight all over. So I'm moving, but it's flowing. It doesn't look like a jerky movement. But I'm tight up here, tight, tight, tight. So I'm moving from these times when my hands are like this. I'm not open, close, open, close. And then you're loose, tight, loose, tight. You have to be firm through the whole kata. When you extend the technique, when you complete the technique, that's when the everything tightens up. So I guess the point is here, keep the hands tight through the whole kata. They don't have to be clenched tight. They need to be closed and tight. And it's also good to keep that in mind because if you're fighting, you get in that mode where I'm going to keep my hands tight. I'm like this, you can't free. If you want to lose, get another kicker, somebody's kicking, you've got to watch that technique. Hands loose, fingers loose, if you hit, you're going to get a very bad jammed finger, broken finger, or broken hand. Good idea to keep it tight. Not everybody. Point for everyone. Keep your hands tight so you have that upper body balance. What shows you off up here? You lose the balance, and you're kind of stable because up here, it's where you're not stable. my kick. I got my hook and I got my hand. No, come, no, go. Work on it. You got it. You have to put that lock of leg and cut it up. Do a good strong kick. I don't care if it's perfect, but I want to teach the power and the kick, the power and the technique, the power and the block. Get tired, that's the whole point. Tired, good workout.